address of your emergency?
It's 2265! Hurry up! My cousin needs help! Hurry up!
I need you to take a deep breath and give me that address again.
Policy and Promotions publication says that potatoes are packed with dietary fiber, nutrients, and potassium. One large potato baked to the skin contains a whopping 1,600 milligrams of potassium.
I do not have time to listen to that. I'm running late for work. Abhita will be down in a little bit. Abhita, I'm gone, honey. I love you.
I love you too.
My name is Abhita Holloway. I'm 13 years old and I live with my mom and grandma. I hate school with a passion. While all the other kids get excited about the first day of school, I get sick thinking about it. The kids are always so mean to me. They call me all sorts of hurtful names, except Todd. He's been my best friend since kindergarten. He might be a little quirky, but he is really nice to me. Anyways, I woke up this morning and I made a decision that will change my life forever.
Hey Todd, we challenge you to do the Universal Kool-Aid Sniff Challenge. What flavor you want? Orange? Grape? Tropical punch?
I did the tropical punch.
I got them all, boy. You can even sprinkle them on your chips.
What you gonna do?
Ew, that's disgusting.
Hey, Brooke. Don't you hate when fat girls come to school looking ugly?
Yeah, she thinks she cute because she so-called got her hair done. It's still not cute.
Hey, Abhita, are you a dyke just like your mom? I know you hear us talking to you, ugly girl.
I'm not bothering you, so please leave me alone.
And if we don't, what are you gonna do about it, stupid?
My little girl being picked on by that big girl out there. Just because she's bigger and she's stronger gives her no right. You hear me? No right.
I always get blamed for stuff because I'm fat and ugly.
Hush your mouth, Abhita.
But it's true, Grandma. I wish I was never born.
Oh, baby, come here. You know, I still remember when you was first born. They was trying to give you all sorts of these ghetto names, like Laudacia. And Bonquisha.
Bonquisha? Thank God they didn't. That's an ugly name.
They thought about naming you Mercedes. I said, y'all ain't naming my granddaughter after no car. That's a stripper's name. No, ma'am. They blessed me with the honor of naming you. And I chose the name you, Abhita. do you know what your name means, baby? It stands for fearless, brave, and courageous. And you have all of those qualities in you, baby. You just have to believe in yourself.
That's easier said than done, Grandma.
All right, I'm ready for you, Miss Holloway.
Come on, baby. It's gonna be all right.
So what did Mr. Henley say?
He gave me in-school suspension for 2 days. But oh boy, my grandma gave him her mind. I wish I was tough like her. She don't play.
2 days? But it wasn't even your fault.
Hey, Todd, ever just thought about being free? Like a bird in the sky? Being able to soar and fly anywhere you want without a care in the world?
Are you okay? Just being able to escape this place,
leave all this stuff behind.
Abhita, are you okay?
Yes, Todd, I'm fine.
Do you want some of my baked potato?
Boy, I don't want none of that. What are you trying to do, turn into a potatonarian?
Abhita, hurry up, honey. We're about to start eating.
I'll be out in a minute, Mama.
Although I had my mind made up already, I thought about everything that happened today, and that helped shape this decision. If I killed myself, I thought the world would be better without me. Everyone can go on with their lives without me to pick on. But that's not true. I have a family that loves me, and I learned today from my grandma that I am truly special. What you saw was what could have happened to me. But I chose to live, because I am fearless, courageous, and brave. I am Abhita.
Oh, there you go.
There you go.
Come on,
man.
Come
on,
with
Gray.
So
1, 2, 3.
So stand in the rain. Sound alone in this.
check this out. This is a movie shot right here in St. Louis. And as you're watching this, you got kids, elementary school or high school, and you think, oh my gosh, they've always wanted to be a movie star. Maybe they want to be in the movies. Well, we're going to be telling you about a talent contest coming up next month, and also tomorrow, a showcase of these films that were shot right here in St. Louis. I've got Lacey Turner and Justin Holmes joining us, and they are from 35 Multimedia.
Yes, sir.
Wow, you guys are really making some serious films here. How many have you made so far?
We've made five, and we just shot one last Sunday.
You just like shot the whole thing on Sunday?
Yep, yeah, shot one day.
So you know what you're doing.
It's a short film, yeah.
Yep, so we're shooting the short films and everything, did it one day, but we have more that we're trying to do. So we're trying to add more value to our event.
That's fantastic. So this weekend, tomorrow, you're going to be showing four films and then also previewing one of them. Tell us about that.
So we're showing, these are four films that I wrote and directed. Abhita, that's a film about, it's based around bullying. We have this film called Stolen, which is about this Caucasian family as they try to rebuild their life. We have Right Hand Man, which is a relationship drama, and Enemy is a short horror film.
So where'd you find all these actors? These are all people living in St. Louis?
Yeah, St. Louis. Like, as doors have begun to open up for me, I try to go around town and, you know, bring people with us and, you know, expose their talent also.
Hey, Margie, you want to be in a movie?
Come on, Margie.
Yeah, we'll be in it.
Come on, Margie.
We could play like news people. We know how to do that. Now, this scene right here we were looking at, there was a fella sitting on a pier, and she's on a phone. Where was this shot?
That was shot in Creve Coeur, actually. Actually, behind some apartment buildings.
Oh, my gosh, that's right in our area here.
Wow.
St. Louis based.
Yep.
And this movie right here is called what?
Right Hand Man. That's the relationship drama.
So how short are they?
Each film runs from probably about 10 to 20 minutes.
Okay. Each of you, what do you do? What's your job with?
Well, I'm the cinematographer, so I actually handle all the post-editing work, and then I'm out there shooting it also. And then I also handle the business of it as far as going to different theaters, talking to them, seeing if they'll be interested in showcasing our work.
Is it difficult when you're a local filmmaking group?
It's a little difficult because you're competing with some of the big acts, you know, that might be showcasing in a weekend, you know, Star Wars, that type of thing, you know, real heavy. They rent out everything.
The whole industry is changing. I mean, you turn on Netflix, they're producing all these movies and these TV shows, Amazon. Everything's up in the air. Your stuff's on, you can put it on YouTube, anywhere.
Yeah.
So now, I'm the writer, director, actor. Try to create powerful content to give out to the world.
Are you guys like starving artists, or are you making money doing this?
I'm making money.
Well, that's good. They're not bragging. It's not bragging if it's true.
Yeah, we have a goal to do actually 300 events this year. So that's our goal. So we're going to do a lot of different films locally, different areas. We're just trying to connect with the theaters now.
That is fantastic.
And we got a powerful team behind us. Team Bars, salute to y'all.
Yeah, well, St. Louis has so many great backdrops for films. I mean, we've got just about, you can make any kind of film here.
Most definitely.
And so let's put up the location. It is tomorrow, 35 Multimedia Screening. It's from 9:30 in the morning until 11:30, and that's at 24-1 Cinema?
Yep.
And that's located where?
Right off Page.
Right off Page
and Ferguson.
And then next month, February, what was it?
10th. Yeah.
Elementary to high school kids can show up, and where's this going to be?
It's going to be at the New Northside Conference Center on February 10th.
All right, you might remember last time the great Henry Davis, the street beat man, was on. You got a glimpse of this movie called The Loo. Would you believe that Henry Davis hooked up with this movie because he actually had a disagreement with the guy who made the movie? Lacey Turner is the filmmaker. He's on with us. He has four short films debuting Sunday morning at the Galleria and a sneak peek at the project called The Loo. And Henry Davis, you are hereby awarded the Nobel Peace Prize for bringing people together, even though you might have divergent points of view.
Yeah.
And even though sometimes you can be a lightning rod.
Yes, sir.
You still have been able to manage to introduce us to a man who is doing great work in this city, who is moving along the dialogue.
Yes, sir.
But who might disagree with the way you approach things your ideas, correct?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. J Money, first of all, I want to thank you for allowing us to be here. My man Lacey here really needs no introduction. He has this film, this Lou thing, and he's on the left. I'm on the right.
Right.
You know, I'm a pro-Trump and he's a no-Trump. But but that doesn't mean that we can't come together.
Right. See, now, how did you guys meet, though, by the way?
A friend of mine who's also playing in his movie, her name is Stacey White.
Uh-huh.
Stacey White, real, real pretty lady and, you know, good person to know, introduced me to him.
Okay.
She just called me up one day. It's like, Henry, I'm in this movie and blah, blah, blah. And I'm like, okay, yeah, right. Let me check it out. And I actually liked it. You know, I don't really like a lot of stuff.
Yeah.
But, and I liked it. I liked how it actually portrays what's really going on in the hood. You know, it's kind of like the play that I'm going to be bringing out next year. It really portrays what's really going on in the hood. You get to see the good side and the bad side of it. Tell me a little bit
now,
about
Lacey,
it.
Now, Lacey, when you then met Henry, mm-hmm. were you like, oh, that's that dude who's on TV and talking about Trump all the time?
I'm like, what? I'm like, this guy wants to talk to me?
Yeah, yeah, right. Yeah, yeah. But nonetheless, you came together. Okay, and so tell me about The Lou. Tell us about it.
So The Lou is a 6-part drama series. It takes place a day after the Darren Wilson verdict, so a day after the riots. And it's you get to go through these 8 friends' lives, and you get to see how their life transpires. They get to try to rebuild. So it shows the perspective of white people, the police officers, the people from the ghetto, and just these different perspectives. I took myself out of my belief and wrote from all these different perspectives to try to create dialogue to try to heal the city.
Wow! So this is more like a novel, really. It's a documentary of sorts. Mm-hmm. But the scenarios you create are characters that you have built.
Yeah, exactly.
I'm excited about taking a look at it because not only, I like to see what else is going on inside of The Lou. Because, you know, a lot of black people don't communicate with me too much. Not, you know, I'm a big Trump supporter. They think, oh, he's a sellout and all of this. But I really am. Oh, I'm from the hood, you know, I support my people. And if you got something going on, holler at me, talk to me, let's get this thing going, which I want to talk to you about. Remember the last time I mentioned, we got this big debate coming up.
Right, yeah. Yeah.
Team Heavy, the original rude boy, Don Dada, you're going to test me now. I got Peggy Hubbard on my team. I got David Hall on my team.
Now, Lacey, you crafted a team too, right?
I got Team Bars, you know, which is a big following, you know. But my team is going to be Stacey White, you know, the great Stacey White, which I just heard.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
My go-getter, Justin Holmes, you know, that's my business partner. And we got a secret weapon. I ain't going to even unleash them.
But
Team Bars.
But the key here is that we're going to put this together.
Yeah.
But the key here is that you all clearly have 2 different positions and 2 different approaches, whether it be to politics, to the economy, to crime, whatever.
Yeah.
And you guys are going to lay them all out.
We're
going
to lay it out. We want you to commentate now. You got to keep us on. Because, you know, when black people get in an argument, we get going. We want you to be able to kind of keep the peace, you know, kind of be, you know, be the mediator. Say, okay, time's up. Because I got a feeling that this is going to be great for the community. It's going to be great for the viewers. It's going to be great for, you know, for everybody to see both sides.
Right.
Because there are some black people in this city that really do like our president, that like the police.
Right.
And that like, you know, what's the direction this country is going in. But then you got that other side.
Right.
You got that other side.
And here, and the reality is, too, the other side cannot be ignored. I mean, because in order for us to be, because I would like to be able to allow the other side, so to speak, to understand where we're coming from.
Right.
But they want us to understand where they're coming from.
Right. Everybody want protest. Everybody want no justice, no peace, and all
Salute.
This. So, you know, we're gonna check it out. Sunday.
10 a.m. to 12 noon at the St. Louis Gallery at the AMC Theater. We're showing 4 of my short films I wrote. The program is called The Greatest Stories Never Told, so you get to see that. And if you come through, you get to see a 10-minute sneak peek of The Lou, the drama series we're talking about. So
I love it.
In order for you to get tickets, you can go to eventbrite.com and type in The Greatest Stories Never Told, or you can reach me at The Greatest Stories Never Told, STL. At gmail.com.
We'll put it all up there on the screen for you, Lacey.
Okay.
And thanks so much for what we're doing.
I appreciate y'all for having me, and we're going to win this debate, Team Bars.
Okay, well, yeah, I can't wait for that. That's going to be fun. And again, you got a lot of people working on the shows you're doing and the movies that you're doing.
Oh, yeah,
so,
man, I got a big team.
Yeah, you're a business.
That's what we call ourselves, Team Bars.
He said he's going to have me in one of his.
That's right. I'm right. I'm on the left side.
All right.
I'm looking forward to it. Thanks, Jay Money.
Thank you so much.
Thanks
you guys are the best.
Partner.
Great to see you, man. Thank you very much, Lacey. Appreciate it very much.
So today's video is how I ended up my first movie. It is a film about bullying, so I was one of the mean girls. It's a short film, so the whole thing is like 7 minutes, and there are probably four or five scenes. And the scene, I was in one scene in the movie, which is the school scene, where I'm one of the bullies who is bullying the lead girl. So that's that. Because it is a short film, I don't have many lines. I have one line. But that doesn't necessarily mean my part was small. Really, my part is pretty crucial to the scene, even though I only have one line. And I also do a lot of other things instead of just, you know, saying that one line. I'm talking to the other mean girls, and we're doing stuff, and we're sort of in the fight scene. The main mean girl only has two lines, even though her part is really crucial to the whole movie. So, because it is a short film, we don't have a lot of lines and we don't have a lot of scenes. But that doesn't mean our part is small. And it's still a great experience. It was still a lot of fun. And I still learned a lot. So, I wanted to share with you guys how it went, how I found the audition, and how I auditioned, and a little bit of what it was like on set. So a little bit, a recap of my experience, my first time experience on set and in a movie. Alrighty, let's go. How I found the audition. Starting January, I've been looking off and on for different projects in where I live. And I never really found anything. Where I live is just not the best place if you want to be in the center of Hollywood. But there are some things going on. So I was just I found a website that lists all the auditions and casting calls in my area. So I've been keeping an eye on that website, and I was scrolling through the website and it said looking for girls my age for a film about bullying. And I'm like, oh, this is so cool. You know, they're actually looking for girls my age. But I'm like, and you know, let's see how many people have submitted themselves for this project. So I clicked on it, and there were like 30 submissions for this project. I'm like, yeah, I don't have a chance. I don't really stand a chance in auditioning for this project, you know. I bet most of these girls have agents and probably know the director and know the school and blah, 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 blah. So I just didn't really feel, I felt like maybe they probably had already cast the parts anyway. So I didn't submit myself for a couple of days, and then I showed it to my mom, and I'm like, okay, what do you think? Should I submit myself? And she's like, yeah, sure, go ahead. You know, it won't really hurt me to submit myself. So I said, oh, hey, and I'm really interested in being a part of your film. It'd be a great learning experience for me, and I'd really love to be a part of your film. Below, I have attached my resume and headshot, and, you know, I guess please consider me. I just tried to make sure that my cover letter, I don't really know how to write a cover letter, but I wanted to show that I was excited, and I wanted to learn experience, and I was willing to learn. I submitted my resume, and I'll talk more about resumes and headshots later. But I just submitted my resume and headshot to the film and just kind of left it at that. I didn't hear back for about 5 days. And I was like, oh, you know, I probably didn't get the part, or I probably won't even get an audition. But then the sixth day, the lady emailed me back, the casting director, she emailed me back and says, oh, okay, well, we still have a spot open, so why don't you read this line? It was just one line for the audition, because my part only has one line. So just why don't you read this line for the audition and send in a video audition. I'm like, okay, I can do that. Video auditions are so much fun because you have a lot of time to practice, it's not nerves, and a whole bunch of other things you don't see. The line of girls waiting to be cast as the same part in the film. So that was a lot of fun. And I practiced the line, and then I videoed and shot myself in my library, which I do not suggest you do. Filming your library is not recommended. You really want to have a blank wall like this. But I filmed in my library, which I'm glad that they didn't mind too much. I sent in the audition, and then a couple days later, she's like, oh yeah, we'd like to offer you the part of Brianna, we have a table meeting and she sent me the script and things like that. And so that was just so cool. I was really blessed by God to even be a part of this film, because as I saw, there were tons of other girls who wanted to be in this movie. And I'm like, they chose me, which makes me feel kind of special. And you know, I'm glad. After that, we went to the table reading, which was a lot of fun. So not all the cast was there, but the main girl and some other kids were there at the table reading. So we just read through the script once, and the cinematographer guy, he would say, "Are you this character?" And I'd be like, "Yeah." And so, and as we were reading the screen, he would kind of go like, he would go like this and like try to see, imagine the scene in the camera, which is kind of weird, but it was pretty cool too. The director came over, and so she talked with us girls about what we were gonna wear that day. For mean girls, you know, you see the scars and you see the boots and the leggings. I don't know, just the typical fashionable outfit with makeup and things like that. She's like, okay, yeah, that's fine. Just bring whatever you can. And so I got to get a shopping for my clothes, which is a lot of fun. And then we shot on January 17th. We shot in a college. They turned a college room into a school room. I was actually kind of nervous about acting in front of a camera. Like, oh my gosh, I can't do this. But I've been practicing my line a lot. And so, just saying it randomly, I'd be over here to say my line. Over here, just say my line. So practice really, really helped prepare me. So even though I was nervous that the camera was gonna be like right here, I knew how I was gonna say it and what I was gonna say and how I looked like when I said that. And I also made a motivation for my character. So I said, okay, even though in the script the character was just a mean girl, I made her be a mean girl with, you know, her parents did this, not to her, but her parents were these kind of parents, and why she was a mean girl, I made her motivation is that she was trying to impress the other mean girl. That's what my motivation was, and that helped me a lot in saying my line and in acting comfortably. So the on-set experience was really, really good. I got to talk to the production assistant, and he explained some things that were happening, like why they use the clapper. And apparently they use the clapper to match up the audio with the audio from the, to match the audio from the sound guy with the audio from the camera. That way they can have better audio. And because it makes a spike in the audio, so they just match up the two spikes together. I would definitely say go for it if you have a chance to be part of a student film. Go for it, it's so much fun, and also it's good for your resume. As you start doing more and more of student films, short films, webisodes, you start putting them on your resume. As your resume builds, it'll help you get an agent and do all sorts of things. So the film is coming out in May, I believe, and they're gonna try to submit it to some film festivals, which is good because that means that I'll have a lot of exposure, and the director actually hopes to win some awards because his last film won an award. Alrighty guys, if you guys have any questions, leave it below. I know this video was sort of long, but I do hope it was helpful and sort of enlightening and not too rambly. Ciao!
What's up, ENT? My name is Lacey Turner, and this is
Justin Holmes.
Hey look y'all, we out here, we trying to build a brand, so we looking for writers, photographers, sound design people, sound engineer people, actors, anything you do in the field of media and filmmaking, we are looking for you. Break it down to them, bro.
All right, so look, you gonna come out, we gonna get this money.
Real time.
You did an amazing job. You are so freaking talented and crazy. I love it.
I loved it. I'm so happy to be part of this project.
It was very creative.
I like this show.
Everything that Lacey does, I'm really drawn to for the truth of it.
I enjoy every bit of it, and we want more.
They put together some awesome projects. I want everybody to come out and support. If you don't, you're going to miss it.
I'd like to see everybody come out and support Lakeland's filmmakers.
CG's Lacey Turner is a mastermind.
You're doing beautiful work, brother. It's all I understand that St. Louis has some amazing talent that is not recognized as much as it should be. So
we're going to see you at the next one?
Oh, yeah, definitely.
Yeah, they did a good job, and I hope I see the next film.
It's always great to see us people out here doing something great.
You are going to love the drama, the suspense, the realness, the truthfulness, all of that.
They say we don't know how to make good movies in St. Louis, so I want to show people that stereotype don't exist.